I think Elliot finally seeing who Keith really was made me understand why I was so upset with Kim.
To bear the weight and push into the sky.
Look who's happy again.
Yeah, well, it's just...
JD, one sec. I'm on the phone, my mom. She just got her RV fixed. Mom, I gotta go. You can call me from the road. My mom loves the road.
I finally figured out what bothered me so much about you.
Well, lay it on me, Studley.
It's the way you're so concerned about protecting yourself. I mean, no one in this entire hospital has a bad thing to say about you, and I'm guessing that's because you're so careful not to rub anyone the wrong way. And you still wear your wedding ring. That prevents any guy from getting anywhere near you. You wouldn't operate on Mr. Peters, and we both know how you're protecting yourself there. I don't know, I guess in the grand scheme of things, it's not that big a deal. I was a little disappointed to find out how you turned out to be. I'll see you around, Kim.
See you.
I don't want to do this.
No problem. I'll just give the videotape to the police.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your chief of medicine, Bob Kelso. I feel compelled to tell you that I do, in fact, fear the janitor. Honestly, is there anyone else with such a brilliant mind?
You planned all this, didn't you? The whole being mean thing so that Keith would stand up for me. Oh, thanks.
You didn't plan a damn thing, did you?
No, I snapped like a twig.
Yeah.
Please don't tell her.
Anyway, I guess people can always surprise you. Who's Dr. Briggs operating on?
Your patient, Mr. Peters.
So, please join me in basking in the glow of the janitor's awesome... This isn't a word.
Read it.
Fearitude. Good night.
And good luck.
I love that movie.
I saw you did that surgery on Mr. Peters. Did you decide it was the right thing to do?
No, actually, it was a stupid career risk.
And why'd you do it?
Because for some reason, I find myself really caring about what you think of me.
Push into the sky, it's easy.